Hey everybody, welcome back. Northern Lion, Binding of Isaac, Rebirth. Hey, this is a new one. I think we have all of the mom's heart kills on hard mode. That's great. We have almost none of the boss rush kills. I think we only have Azazel. So that's going to be our next little grinding out accomplishment here. So every second counts. Pause it as quickly as we can. This is Isaac PK6E. PK6E! That's my impression of Ness. After hard times, and he has turned to male stripping. PK6E8XPD. Let's get out of here. So I'm not gonna keep the I was gonna say thermometer. Oh, that is terrible. I'm not gonna keep the clock up at all times. That shouldn't let that happen again, I'll tell you that much. I'm not gonna keep the clock up at all times. I might not even keep this run up, because it appears that we're gonna die about 2 seconds. We lived. Can somebody check? Am I breathing still? Two good pills. I'm not gonna take them until I finish this room. Come on, be good though. So that's like the worst first room I think I've ever had in Rebirth. Largely my own fault. Largely also the game's. Two luck upgrades. You know, I'll take it. I'm not loving the position we're in. Like five bombs right at the bat is pretty sweet too. But we need to actually find. Oh my god, are you kidding me with this horse effing hockey here? Hey, we got to run where we got to you know, beat the game as quickly as possible. It's gonna be pretty tough. How about I give you like the worst first room of all time, and then you can fight the boss that everybody hates fighting on the first floor because it takes 300 fucking years. This is just sad, man. Like, this is just not a good start. But you know me, so it's the same old G. I'll restart if we have to restart, and I'll just put two seeds in the video description. If people complain about spoilers, I'll say I fucking died on the first floor, you know? Spoilers, Christian Bale becomes Batman. Spoilers, I don't watch enough movies to know it. Spoilers, Robert Downey Jr. Becomes Iron Man. Spoilers, Tobey Maguire becomes Spider-Man. Spoilers. I'm gonna check for second secret rooms. At this point, we pretty much just gotta, you know, we gotta go hard, you know? Another big room, by the way. So let's go down our rooms. That could have easily killed me. Thus far, we've had a 2x room, a 4x room, an envy fight, and that's it. So this is probably the slowest first floor that I've ever seen. And we're probably still gonna die in the process. It would not surprise me at all. Where you at though, dog? There you are. Okay. Tried to sneak a little sneaky deaky one in there. Didn't work. PhD, it's good enough, and thank you for the HP. So maybe I am gonna keep the clock up here at all times, because it's kind of making me feel a little bit more reassured about things right now, to be honest with you. To be honest with you, I'm actually like, I'm feeling pretty good about that, if you don't mind me saying so. Because of our very, shall we say, unique situation, where pretty much we've been so slow already that I kind of feel like we pretty much just have to pull out all the stops if we're going to get to this boss rush room. If we don't get to the boss rush room, by the way, this run is not lost. I was looking for second secret room. We could still just try to get further in the game than we've ever gotten as Isaac on hard mode, which would not be that hard. I don't even think we've had a cathedral kill with Isaac. So this, at least, is not, you know, for naught if we can't get to our boss room, but or if we can't get to our boss rush room. But I tried to go to the curse room thinking there might be an item in there. Maybe you get a guppy item, reroll it, then you get another guppy item. And then you're cooking with gasoline, but no such luck. And then we're gonna fight gurglings, probably like the bosses that I'm most likely to take 100 years to kill on this floor. This is actually like my definition of the worst first floor of all time. Now, it wouldn't have been so bad if I didn't do so poorly. This is how much I hate this. I was gonna say, despite like a hard mode pissing me off with the lack of consumables, I used a bomb. And the bomb fucking won. Unfortunately. I didn't use the bomb, man. The bomb used me. Fuck you, pageant boy. Yeah, there we go. Tears upgrade. All that for a tears upgrade. Feeling pretty good. Let's keep our clock active here. I said clock. Rock out with your clock out, guys. 351. We're gonna have to speed this the fudge up here if we're going to have any chance. The tiers upgrade, the shot speed upgrade, it's a start. It's extra damage. That's way more important than Pageant Boy, especially on a hard mode run where we don't even know if we're going to get any freaking keys. I would be going to this curse room in a heartbeat were it not for the fact that our black heart here might actually be the most important thing in the world to us. If it gets us a deal with the devil, that gives us a good offensive item. That goes a long way. Speaking of which, I am going to look for our secret room, like right here, in the hopes that we can bomb our way into our curse room for free. Alrighty. That's alright. You live and you learn. We got another bomb back anyway. I was guaranteeing that was going to happen. Not even a doubt in my mind. Maybe now we can bomb our way into the item room instead, because it doesn't look like we're going to be able to bomb our way into the curse room. But we'll try to go to our curse room regardless, because Guppy could give us a great chance of getting our boss rush room happening here. That's just empty bullshit. There is a tinted rock. That's what I was looking out for. No, don't push it. We got our key back. It's all worth it. You're not really supposed to take 5 minutes on your first two floors. Oh, fudge off, game. Dad's key. Dad's key is actually really good on hard mode, but we cannot really justify it right now. Yeah. I mean, we could use it. Actually, you know what? The Dad's key does allow you to get the boss rush room even if you didn't earn it. But we'd have to get rid of the D6. And honestly, after the last run, that's just something I'm not willing to do right now. I'm sorry. We're going to have perfect timing here. Of course, let's fight another boss that spends like half of its time being a pain in the freaking butthole. So I can't even do damage to it the vast majority of the farkin' time. Like, can you just... Hey, Northern Lion's going for the boss rush room. How about we give him no fucking damage and put him up against, like, the most annoying high HP fucking, you know, turtling enemies in the whole game? Whatever. I don't care. I'll buy broken stopwatch from the shop and then you'll all be sorry. We'll take stem cells. Work with me here. Work with me. Ah, it's good. It's good. Okay. All is forgiven. Mom's knife, little brimstone. A combination of all the items that people hate when I take. Now we're going to start making progress. And see, if you complain enough, sometimes you get what you want. Blank card. There are so many good uses for this. Now we're not going to get another reroll. So I think now it's time to make up a little bit of our time, you know? We're going to start to go a little faster now, if you don't mind. Damn, baby, I can't do it that fast, but I know someone who can. Twister, come on. Anyway. By going fast, I of course mean let's immediately mire ourselves in the fucking miasma of mob trap rooms with enemies who, again, are largely just bullshit. But we should be able to go a staggering degree faster now, which is great. We got a range up so I can settle down. We'll take that. We got a luck up. This is all shaping up pretty nicely after that really rocky start. I apologize, by the way. I know a lot of people are going to be like, hey, don't leave that clock up. I actually agree with you. I find it kind of annoying and cumbersome, even though I know a lot of people who are high-level Isaac players keep it up there. Just personal preference for me, at least. We'll go quickly, but we'll keep the clock off for a couple of floors here until we absolutely know, or need to know, I should say, whether we're in a dire position or a good position. Because, you know, you keep it up there, it's a subconscious message to yourself that you got to go faster, which is good. But also could potentially lead to mistakes. And I think because of the damage that we're doing now, we don't need to worry as hard about our timing. Like, we're going to be going very quickly now. I will go to our curse room. We'll take the mark. We'll get ready to reroll those. Yeah, if we can take that deal with the devil, we'll need HP first. If we can take our reroll into the deal with the devil, that might be good. I hate this room. Lucky us, although I do have to immediately go back through it, but good start, I'd say. Okay, there is a tinted rock down here. Don't think I don't see it. I don't know how we're going to get to it. We'd have to fly. Talk to Sugar Ray about that one. Alright. Well, I think we end up fighting our boss. We don't have to be quick. I'm in full, like, rush mode right now. We don't have to be in a modern-day warrior, mean strat, today's top Sawyer, mean pride, you know? Oh, I would like to reroll that, and that's, I think, a good choice. And then maybe we could take Guppy's hairball, but I don't know. I think we're better off just being where we're at. We couldn't have taken an item there without rerolling it anyway, so... We're gonna slow down just for a brief moment here. And we're gonna blow this up to hopefully get a key. Got a bomb back. Well, we're under 10 minutes. And it's gonna get faster as time goes on. So my thinking is, you know, let's actually make the effort and we'll go up here and try to get to our item room. We'll do everything in our power to do so. And hopefully it'll work out. And if it doesn't, at least we tried, and it probably won't end up affecting our timing too much. With two bombs, oh, that is totally not the secret room, but I have to kind of look for it. Yeah, it's definitely not the secret room adjacent to that item room. Could have gone to the curse room for free. Dude, the forget me now is so bad, though. It's a really bad item for us. Oh, well. Still very happy with this floor. Meat's a good upgrade. You know, we got something on our deal with the devil that I've now forgotten. It was good. How could I have possibly forget? It was good. We got Mom's Knife and Little Brimstone on the last one. Was it just a... Oh, it was the Pact, right? I think it might have been the Pact. Anyway. I'm actually, like, I'm troubled by the fact that I've forgotten what that item was so quickly. But that's, you know, I got the boss rush on the brain right now. Careful. Oop. I really don't like this. This room is the real Curse of the Labyrinth right here. Even if we get no keys, we have a pretty realistic chance of doing okay on this run regardless. Little Brimstone. Oh, it's a Tinted Rock right there. Little Brimstone, a surprisingly nice addition with Mom's Knife. Lucky me. Good. Little not as... You know, spectacular as I'd like it to be, but that's okay. Ruka, you just freaking sit there, okay? You take a nap. Don't be getting up on my desk like Tomo does. I can see it in your eyes that you desire to be up here. I'd like to, just like for some perspective, I'd like to live as a cat for a day. A lot of people say, like, you know, oh, wouldn't it be nice to be a cat? You got nothing in the world to worry about. You just kind of sleep all day and eat this shitty food. And then live your life. Honestly, sounds fucking boring as hell to me. But I'd like to be a cat for one day so I could at least get some perspective. So when I'm like, why do you care so much about my desk? You know, I wouldn't have to ask about that anymore. I would have some perspective and I'd be able to say, like, oh, that's why you care about my desk. Because you're like, what is this shit? Desk doesn't exist in the wild, man. We got no evolutionary programming for how to deal with a freaking desk. Old bandage. I think we'll take it. We could use the HP. Now, we have some time. I'm toeing the line with Discord and Rhyme. I'm on the hunt, I'm after you. We're not necessarily having to go super quickly, and we don't have all the time in the world, but we don't have to rush to the point where we're leaving behind stuff unnecessarily. Now, it may come to pass that we actually just cannot access our item room. And if that happens, that sucks. But if we can access our item room, it's worth the attempt here. Too bad we didn't go to our boss trap room earlier. Man, it's so nice to have Mom's Knife. Why stand right next to an enemy that explodes when you kill it? So nice to have Mom's Knife and not have a tiny planet associated with it. That's what I'm thankful for today. That's gonna trick you guys into thinking that I recorded this like Thanksgiving weekend, but really, that would be ages ago. Rebirth wasn't even out with Thanksgiving weekend. Happened. We have Canadian Thanksgiving. I hate calling it Canadian Thanksgiving. Because it's bullshit. Whenever... I got on some people's nerves on Thanksgiving. Not really on their nerves. Most people just thought it was funny. But I tweeted, like, whoa, you guys have Thanksgiving in America as well? They laughed. But I hate the idea that American Thanksgiving is default, you know? Or default, sorry. Used every one of my available resources to make myself sound Canadian, but I, you know, your country's version of a holiday is not the default version of a holiday. for the most part. Canadian Thanksgiving is Thanksgiving, dog. It's just Thanksgiving in Canada. I don't want to call it Canadian Thanksgiving. It's Thanksgiving. But anyway. Whoa, you have Thanksgiving up there? Crazy. We're just a thankful people in general, you know? I am very thankful for the fact that I did not pick up Tiny Planet by accident. No keys. So sadly, we invested another 2 minutes and only lost in the process. I don't think there's really anything I could have done to give myself more keys either. More keys and mind keys. What are you doing there, Ruka? Have you decided that it's time to leave this room after 11 minutes of restful relaxation and slumber? Oh no, you're just gonna go sit on my sock that is on the ground. Cats are like a highlighter for personal shame. Like, if you leave some laundry on the ground, you're like, you should really put that in the hamper. The cat's like, what, this thing that I'm sitting on right here, drawing your attention to? We're a little bit ahead of the curve. You saw the clock there. Getting to the point where we might want to start thinking about keeping that clock up at all times. Maybe not quite yet. Because we didn't get a deal with the devil on the last floor, we should be in a pretty much guaranteed position to get one on this floor. Which is good. You know, we got our rerolls set up. Apparently, boss rooms and devil rooms are the only way we can actually obtain items anymore, so I'm thankful for that. Whenever they would like to show up, I'll be happy to oblige. Mary J. Oblige. Easy room. Like, a single key wouldn't kill you, though. It's not like I've even wasted keys. For some reason, like, I feel guilty about the fact that we haven't had any keys, but it is actually outside of my control. We've gone to every room on the past two floors, and we just have no keys. I may have opened a golden chest on the first floor or the second floor, but I don't think I did. I think that might have been last run. We'll open those. We got a key here, finally. The game was like, you know what, you're right, I'm being kind of an asshole. Spirit hearts are good. Pills, I think one of those is a range upgrade. Oh, one of them is balls. We have PhD, right. Whatever. I'm not going back for it. That was really stupid. I was trying to dodge to, like, take both pills at the same time. At least we got to leave with balls of steel. That was a terrible bit of damage right there. I'm not mad about it. I'm a little perturbed by the fact that I suck, but that's it. We'll live with it. And this floor's been pretty great so far. We are gonna have to go back down there. 5 minutes. It's putting us in a bit of a tight spot here. You know, means I'd really like to get into that boss fight within the next 4 minutes. If we can get in there, you know, we got Mom's knife, so we've got Mom's knife, so we don't need to be too concerned. As long as we have like 30 seconds, we should be pretty much guaranteed to beat Mom. But we do have to get there in 30 seconds, which is not always easy. That's a really good trinket for us. Another very easy room. Especially when we can just do cheesy shit like that. Black Bean, pretty bad. Midas Touch, not amazing, but if we get the ability to have some sort of invincibility, especially on the regular, that could be great for us. Boss room's gotta be close. And bombs are key. I'm basically gonna turn this other bomb into our next item room, if I can. Hopefully we have the time necessary to get to our next item room. It's gonna be tight. Pretty much everywhere, it's gonna be tight. Starla? Well, I don't need a habit. Anyway, though, adversary's gonna die. Quickly-ish. And he should give us a charge, and he did. And we get Fear Shot, which is also a damage upgrade, so I'll take it for sure. And then we'll reroll our speed plus range upgrade into HP, which is like the oldest story in the storybook. And we have Fear Shot, which is also a damage upgrade, as mentioned. That's good. Now we'll put this up. So we got 3.5 minutes of which to beat Mom. That, honestly, should not be that tall of an order. And mind you, we have to get into the room first, which is really going to be what takes us the most time. That was not smart. I'd say we have about two more minutes of free floor time before we gotta make our run to the boss room. We don't have enough consumables to make that worthwhile. I almost walked into that door. I didn't realize it was a gated door until it was almost too late there. Could have opened that with a key. I would have felt like an idiot. Luckily, we don't have a key, I guess. Good. Good. A little Brimstone Mom's Knife combination working out pretty nicely. 17 and a half. 19 is where the danger zone starts to come into play, I think. I knew we were going to take damage, or at least I had a strong inkling that was going to happen. But I figured, you know, it's best to get as many of these guys in one hit as we can. There's our item room. Bombs are key. D20 gets rerolled in a Book of Sin. I was really hoping that would drop a battery. Gave us a two of clubs. Too bad we didn't use that before. We would have had more keys. We'll reroll Book of Sin if we have a chance. Remember, like, our main goal is just to get all of our post-it notes filled out. There's our boss room. It's to get all of our post-it notes filled out. Now, if we get the boss rush taken care of, even if we die on this run, I'll consider it a success. We have about 45 extra seconds in which to explore the rest of this floor. I do want to go to some more rooms because it just makes sense to me to go to as many rooms as possible. Maybe get a charge that we could use on the boss room in case our boss rush items, I should say, are shit. In fact, it's probably much smarter for me to reroll, or for me to plan at least to reroll our boss rush because there's more items there. And if we don't, well, we can reroll whatever drops us at the end. So we're going to go for it right now. We will get a full charge thanks to the trickle charge, AAA battery. Careful. Foot should be coming down any second now. There we go. Red Mom is easy Mom. Bad damage, that's okay. We should have time to get into our Deal with the Devil room, which is maybe where we want to spend a charge as well. We don't have a Deal with the Devil room. Okay. We'll take our Polaroid. Boss Rush Room. Odd Mushroom is good. Fear Anemia is okay. Maggie's Bow is okay. Makes hearts heal for double. But I think we want, like, Eve's Mascara is, like, another Fear Shot or something? Shot Speed down plus damage up. That was not even close. But, okay, our Shot Speed's gonna be bad, but our damage is gonna be excellent. I don't know. If you gave me the choice there, and even if I had known exactly what Eve's Mascara had done, I don't know, this might be the first time we picked up Eve's Mascara outside of a curse room. Or sorry, outside of a challenge run is what I mean. But I probably would have gone with Odd Mushroom, because it seems like Odd Mushroom does the same thing, except no shot speed down, plus it gives you HP. I know, Aruka, it makes me feel like a big dummy. But it seems like, correct me if I'm wrong, it seems like Eve's Mascara gives you a pretty flippin' sweet damage upgrade. Not just like, hey, here's your token damage upgrade. This is like a really kind of potent damage upgrade. It's just my guess, you know, it might be wishful thinking. But let's see. Let's get a good, like a nice decent shot on Loki in it. That was crazy good. Alright, I'm content with this decision. And we do still have, there were enough good items that there was no way I was using a reroll. We gotta worry about just surviving here, by the way, but there's no way I was just gonna reroll what we had going on there, because we had some great stuff. But now we have a reroll that we can use at the end if they drop an item that we don't want. And I think it's fairly likely that we end up surviving boss rush. But, you know, on a hard mode, it's tough, man. Hard mode, you get so many fewer consumable drops. We just one-shot Gish. So you know what? I don't think we would have been able to do that without the mascara. What spawned there? Pins? Wow, that was good. Yeah, okay. Just play it like very, very cool here because, you know, it might look good, but there are other enemies that can F with your day. And you can't really anticipate, watch out for bloat here. You can't really anticipate too many spirit hearts dropping. So you just want to sneak behind bloat here. Do as much damage as you can. Yeah, well, you're in a safe place. Where's my heart at? There it is. Good stuff. Mask won't be able to stand up to much more strain than that. We're almost done, actually. We're doing crazy damage. Please tell me it's Blue Famine. Ah, it's not Blue Famine. Thought Little Brimstone would be able to finish the job there. Okay, two more waves. Regular edition of war. Gotta get... Oh my god, that was crazy. Do we get, like, rage for this or something? Because it really does seem like, like, we're doing so much more damage than I would expect. Careful. There we go. Just the pony left. That was a really good boss rush room. And we didn't get an item. Maybe we've already done boss rush? Alright, I'm actually content with this. I rerolled X-ray goggles and got HP, but I think that's a good choice for us. It allows us to survive more in the future. At the very least, I'm sure you have to fill up these post-it notes for Platinum God, so I don't feel bad about it. This is going solidly. I would very much like to be a member of Cat Fancy this month, if you know what I mean. If we could just get some guppy action here, that would be lovely. But we are already nearly one-shotting every enemy we come across. Now, it doesn't matter that much on the womb. It's not a guarantee, because we're going to be coming across a lot of enemies. Ruka buddy, my man. You cheering me on, or do you just want to get some dried animal pellets in the next room? I can probably guess. Well, lucky us. Wow, that was bad. Lucky us, though, because we do have our probable deal with the devil here. All we got to do is not take two hits against Skolex. Maybe one. I don't know. Good start. Ruka, I'll let you out in just a second, bud. You can't understand English, but... Alright, I'm okay with this. I prefer that reroll. Alright, Ruka. What's up, dog?
Say my name. There you go. Goodbye.
Now, I can pretty much promise you that in about 15 seconds, my other cat, Tomo, is going to come bleary-eyed out of the windowsill behind my monitor and is going to be like, "What? Where did Ruka go?" And then he's going to slowly put together the pieces, and then he's going to want to go outside as well. So just, you know, setting your realistic expectations for what you may come to see in just a few moments here. That was a great little bit of damage on my part. Let's make it even worse by going into our curse room. Oh, but we did get transferred into this room, which I actually don't give a shit about. All right. Now we're down to only our red hearts, but I kind of like it. You know, it keeps us on the edge, keeps us hip and fresh, and keeps us honest here. A little scary. Oh, there he is. Hey, Tomo, what's up, buddy? Wasn't Ruka here a minute ago? Even though we weren't even close to one another, I was only in this room because Ruka was in the room. And now he's not in the room. What am I supposed to do? What am I doing now? He's not up there. That's like his normal spot. It's all right, buddy. I know. Just embrace it, right? Here he goes. Walking towards the... No, that's just more of my laundry. You know what? Let's use two of clubs. Take the Emperor's card with us. Oh, actually, Tomo! He's being way more industrious than I expected. He's just taking Ruka's old spot. This has been the play-by-play of, you know, the life of me and my cats. It's a Lifetime original movie. Hey man, if Grumpy Cat can get one, Tomo should get one too. He kind of looks like Grumpy Cat, except he's like, you know, largely quite nice. Not that Grumpy Cat isn't nice, that's me projecting, man, because that cat has resting bitch face, you know? It's not really fair, that cat could be the sweetest cat in the whole world. Careful, careful. Don't have to be so careful about this guy. He's ages away. Okay. I love our chances, by the way, against Mom's hearts. Comes a little bit more cumbersome when we have to beat Isaac, because the cathedral could whittle us down. But I think we could... Like, this is not an that's not good. This is not an unlikely win, though. Especially now that we've just gotten back to full health. Now, it only takes one room being a bit shitty for us to be in a difficult situation. But I do think that we... Oh, come on. You know, I think we can win this, is what I'm trying to get at in a very, very roundabout fashion, apparently. Not good. No, even worse. Okay, take a second and enjoy yourself. There are no red hearts I'm missing, so we're just gonna have to beat Mom's heart without getting hit. Guess how much I enjoy the idea of beating Mom's heart without getting hit. Even if we could only get hit once, it would be so much easier. Being able to not get hit at all is a problem. And now we won't be able to get hit on any room for the rest of the game. Alrighty then. No problem. Curse of the maze. Thank you. Red hearts. Red hearts. We in the red heart district? No? Okay. Ah, oh, yeah. Fuck. Well, we got the boss rush done. It's another thing checked off the post-it notes. How are we doing item-wise? 321 still? Yeah, we're getting a little bit more checked off. As of right now, though, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the run. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And, of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.